press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi students, in the previous video we have discussed about the p-n junction forward bias and reverse bias characteristics. Come to know, the diode conducts in the forward bias condition when P is connected to the positive terminal, one n-type is connected to the negative terminal of the external source battery, and large current establishes and it conducts in that condition if the applied voltage is higher than the barrier potential. But at the same time, under reverse bias, when p-type is connected to the negative terminal and n-type to the positive terminal, there is no current. Maybe the minority current negligible, it will not conduct. Therefore, we told in the reverse bias, p-n junction is not conducting, in the forward bias only conducts. Therefore, it is called as a unidirectional conducting device. On the basis of this property, we are going to see today one of the application as a rectifier. Before that, just I am coming what we discussed in the last class, numerical section for the entrance concern. It is now taken the forward bias. You know, diode positive terminal is connected to the P side and negative terminal connected to the N side. Suppose if you are given in the words in the entrance forward bias diode, for an ideal diode, in the forward bias almost resistance is zero. Forward resistance is zero. And this is the supply voltage they give in terms, maybe the 30 volt, for example, it may be 30 volt given. Forward bias they may given the 2 volt, the forward bias of the, sorry, forward bias voltage here, potential barrier is 2 volt. Then the questions may come of different types, RS given, how to find out the values different they are asking. So the question comes, if they given the circuit and asking you about the current, this is not allowing the current to flow, therefore this much has to be subtracted. Up to this to neutralize, no current flows, therefore supply voltage is VF. Supply voltage is VF, it is not solely contributing for current. This opposing agency's value should be deducted. Why I taken minus? Because it opposes the applied voltage. Therefore, VF minus VB is the effective voltage which can establish the current in the circuit. I told already in the forward bias characteristic, when the applied voltage become higher than the barrier potential, then the diode starts conducting fairly. Therefore, VF minus VB. If it is normal diode, not an ideal diode, has a finite forward resistance, in the forward bias characteristic we calculated it may take any value between 0 to 100 ohm. So in that case, resistance of the diode and resistance, limiting resistance used to control the current in the circuit, not to damage the diode, we are used to manage this in series with the diode, a limiting resistor. Limiting resistor plus forward resistance, total resistance in the circuit, effective voltage. I told you why minus sign used. This ratio help you to calculate the current. Many times the question comes on this. And this equation is an equation completely on the basis of the charge carriers. Current, forward current is I naught. I naught is the reverse saturation current we discussed already previously. Only limited minority carriers under reverse bias condition constitute a current which we called it as a reverse saturation current, that value. E to the power of EV by KT, where V is the supplied voltage, E is the charge of carrier, K is a Boltzmann constant, T is the absolute temperature at which the diode is functioning. This value gives you the current. But in case of forward bias, this ratio E to the power of EV by KT is very large compared to 1. That is, E to the power of EV by KT minus is very much greater than 1. Therefore, this minus 1 is neglected and this is the expression for current. Sometimes this question directly appeared in the entrance. What is the power drop? Power drop across the diode means, you know, power is equal to current into voltage. What is the voltage? Barrier potential, VB. What is the current established? IF. IF into VB gives you the power drop. This P is a power drop across the diode. power drop across the diode is given by that. What is the power drop across the resistor means? What is the supply voltage VF? What is the effective voltage is VF minus VB, as you did here, multiplied by the forward current gives you this. Otherwise, I have to write it as IF into VR. VR is nothing but VF minus VB. Power drop across the resistor, power drop across the diode, current that can establish in the diode. Now, you know, in the forward bias, we told that we have to supply energy to the holes to cross the junction to diffuse with the electron. What is in the unbiased condition? There is a barrier potential which objected the further diffusion. That implies energy of the holes become equal to that of the energy of the barrier. Therefore, hole is failed to cross over the junction and fuse with the electron. That means in unbiased condition, minimum energy required for the holes to cross the junction and to diffuse the electron is E into VB. V is the charge of the hole, VB is the barrier potential. Potential into charge is the energy. That much of energy already barrier is having. If it is at least, it is not have that much, means it cannot cross. That is what in unbiased condition, as the holes have this much, the diffusion process was stopped, ceased. Suppose we supply more energy, then again it may chance. So here forward bias condition, the energy necessary will be equal to E into VB minus VF. It is a forward biasing condition. In the reverse bias, it is a plus VB plus VR. It is the supplied voltage, it is a forward biasing voltage supplied. This gives you the energy necessary in unbiased condition under forward bias for the holes to cross the junction and to diffuse or constitute a diffuse current. In the reverse bias, this relation you have to remember for entrance point of concern. I hope you are understood. In the reverse bias, the question may come majorly on the current. This equation you remember because minority carriers. This point you remember, for ideal diode, the resistance is infinity and do not conduct electricity at all. Therefore, other talkings are meaningless. And here I told reverse bias condition and I naught, reverse saturation current equal to minus I naught. That saturation current we discussed in the graph. This is what, with the extension of this idea, we go to one of the application of the PN junction as rectifier. Rectifier, what rectification is and how this diode property of unidirectional conduction helping us to convert AC into DC. One of the application of PN junction diode. So rectification here is converting AC into DC. Suppose this is a device which I am calling it as a rectifier. This, if you are giving an input here, the input is an AC. Maybe the voltage or current, I am representing in terms of voltage. You know, AC is pulsating for every half cycle, periodic variation. It is a positive pulse and a negative pulse. And similarly, this will run. For every half cycle, the direction of flow of current changes in AC. That you know. This rectifier of two categories, half wave and full wave. So if I talk about the half wave rectifier, the output when you draw here from the rectifier, you are seeing the output voltage across this. So if it is a half wave, means only half of the one wave, there are two pulses, one positive and negative pulse. Positive pulse is rectified. Rectified means you will get the output plus signal is coming out. But the negative signal is removed. How removes? Let us see. But I am explaining what rectifier will do. So negative direction is remove means direction changing is ceased. Again positive pulse of the other wave comes here, this become absent. Now again it is positive pulse appear. Again this become absent. Positive pulse appear. What we see is it is a pulsating DC. See, direction concerned no changes. Direction is same. But magnitude is varying. It varies in magnitude but unidirectional. Conducts in one direction but magnitude of the voltage is not remained constant. Such rectification called as a pulsating. We get the pulsating voltage, there is a frequency no doubt, but it is not change the direction. One directional pulsating DC we get. Every half cycle will be removed and only half the cycle may come. Suppose if it is a full wave rectifier instead of that, full wave. So this negative pulse is also has to change the direction. The pulse is reversed in polarity and you will get the negative pulse same. Now we call it as a full wave rectifier. In this also you are seeing voltage is not constant. DC current is or voltage is variable. Magnitude is varies. It is a pulsating variable, which I call it as a variable DC comes when you take out of the rectifier. Variable DC. Steady DC means you will get like this. Stabilized output with respect to the constant, almost constant voltage. Now we are getting of this type. To get this steady DC, we use capacitor filter, a filter circuit. If you pass the rectifier output to a filter, output of the rectifier is given to the RC filter circuit, it rectifies that error and make you to get a steady DC output voltage. That means there are process three. Input voltage should be reduced to the required magnitude using a transformer. And they have to be passed through the reduced voltage has to be passed through the diodes to get either half wave or full wave rectification. Whatever the rectification comes is a variable DC. This variable DC may be made smooth and constant DC by passing through a filter circuit. Three stages, and how this takes place, let us see one by one. First, I hope the process of converting AC into DC is called as rectification. So that rectification. Rectification means the process of converting alternating current AC into DC is called rectification. Half the wave is rectified, then it is called as a half wave rectifier. The device which converts only half the wave of AC, half the wave of AC, then it is called as a half wave rectifier. The circuit which converts AC into DC is called as a rectifier. Process is called as a rectification. Only half the wave is rectifying, then we call it as a half wave rectifier. Let's see the circuit is how. So here we need a transformer. I told you how, what is the functioning of the transformer also. I think you are studied in electromagnetic induction, EMI theory. Here we supply the AC means through this. It is an input part and the output part. What is a load resistor? It is a diode, P and N, primary of the transformer, secondary of the transformer. This is called as a transformer points B and E. The output is taken across this load. This is the block diagram, circuit diagram of the half wave rectifier. So AC signal is given at the input. So the voltage input is appear to be of the form. The plus and minus signal as explained now, it is the input waveform. Of AC. You know the transformer, primary of the transformer, when the current flows in this in one direction, the reverse direction in the secondary flows due to mutual induction. Mutual induction principle it operates. The transformer is used to brought down the voltage what necessary at the output. Transformer role is to step down or step up the input voltage. What the voltage we required from the input can be adjusted with this transformer. Suppose if you are stepping down or step up, step down if you imagine, so that voltage comes, but directional of the current is reversing. Here if it is current flows like this, in this will be it is opposite. That's what we are seeing in this situation. So let us think how this operates. You know, forward bias diode conducts. Reverse bias, it won't conduct. This you keep in mind. That you point also remember, as I told in the earlier class, plus is connected to P and minus is connected to N, then we call it as a forward bias. This keeping in mind, let us see here, reduced output may come from the transformer at the terminals A and B. So let us take this pulse, which is taken as a positive one. Positive pulse. Now it is zero and maximum. I consider here it is zero, or I can take plus and minus, better to follow. So if it is minus, at this zero I considered as a minus, this is a higher positive value as a plus at this point. It may be A dash and B dash of the transformer level. As here it is reversed, positive to minus means current flow like this in this. Now the current established in this will be of this direction. Because this is minus, current here it is anti-clockwise, means in the secondary clockwise, this is at a higher potential than B. So in the positive half pulse, A is appear to be positive and B is negative. See this connection. P is connected to the positive terminal, N is connected to the negative terminal. For this chance, the diode is under forward bias. Diode is under forward bias. This is a resistor across which we take the output. The resistor used to take the output is called as a load resistor. We are drawing the output through that. Current flows, current into resistance gives you the voltage. As the current established in this forward current into RL gives you the output voltage. For example, if IF is the forward current, IF is the forward current and RL is the resistance, is the output voltage we get here. And if I draw the curve for the graph of this, for the output concerned, V output, you are seeing that the pulse is emerged. This pulse is appeared correctly in the forward bias, because the transformer output is such that A is positive or at a higher potential than B. That means B is at lower potential. That I give you another figure, I forgotten to tell you in the diode. In this forward bias, there are many situations how we can judge the forward and reverse bias cases. For example, if you take a diode like this, forward biasing how judge is, I tell you. That if it is P and N, now it is a 5 volt means it may be 0. It is forward bias, higher potential, lower potential. So the same, I show you, if it is not like that, let us think if it is a zero, it must be higher, means it may be minus 5 volt. It is 0 volt. Or 0 volt, it is not given. If they are earthed, then also it is a 0 volt. Now 0 minus 5, when consider 0 is at higher potential than minus 5, forward biased. Or you can think it may be the minus 2 volt and minus 5 volt. Minus 2 volt is higher potential than 5 volt, positive. Or you can think it is a 10 volt and 5 volt, higher potential. I shown you the different cases. Maybe grounded and connected to like this. Maybe minus 2 volt and 0. So these are the two cases I shown, simply the forward bias. Or another one, forward bias, simply that overcome your confusions is minus 3 volt and minus 8 volt. This end must be at higher potential and this end may be at lower potential. Then we say the diode is under forward bias. So that happened here, it is at higher potential than this and it is conducting and current is established. Current into resistance given you the output voltage. We got the pulse. Let us think about the negative pulse here. So diode, what happens in this, look into. In the negative pulse, this become positive. Current reverses the direction and takes clockwise sense, and A dash become positive and B dash become negative. Current in the primary. What happens here, this voltage, here it is becoming lower potential and this become higher potential. It is come to the lower potential. Thereby the current almost becomes zero in the load resistor now. Almost zero. You know, under reverse bias, diode is not conducting, negative terminal. I given you the picture. So this you understood. I am changing in this only. So otherwise I write, laterally remove. Minus is connected to P and positive terminal is connected to N. This become a reverse bias. And I show the diode situation at a lower potential than this. Now it is at lower potential and it must be at the higher potential should come. Higher potential should come. That means here it is lower, means if it is a zero, so it is grounded, let us assume. Zero at lower potential mean it must be at a high voltage, 5 volts. Or you can take an example similar to the above. Suppose if it is at minus 5 volt, it must be at minus 2 volt. Minus 2 volt is higher, this is at a lower potential. Or you can take the example so that minus 5 volt, now it may be 2 volt, it may be 10 volt. 10 volt is higher than this. These cases are reverse bias. The similar situation is happening here. It is negative, means lower potential, and it is come to be at higher potential. Almost the current in the reverse bias is zero. When current is zero, output is zero and become absent. You are not get the pulse at all. No pulse visible. Pulse is absent. Let us think the another positive half cycle of the another wave. Then again you will get the output, no doubt. Because once again this end becoming negative and this become positive, current become anti-clockwise and this become higher potential and this become the lower potential, and current establishes and output appears. For every positive half cycle you are getting the output. It is the output waveform. DC output waveform of AC of DCR, DC output waveform, that is output voltage. This is majorly asking you in the exam, not those figures. You may be asking what is half wave rectifier, and with block diagram explain the functioning of the half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier is a electronic circuit or a device in which half the wave of the AC is rectified. Only half the wave of the AC or signal, AC signal is rectified and other half is removed. made zero. So the circuit diagram contains one transformer and a diode. One diode, one transformer and a load resistor is enough to get the output. What we do, the input is given to the primary of the transformer. Thereby, the transformer step down the voltage to the required value. As it is AC, per every half cycle, polarity of the voltage or the current is reversing in the primary. Similarly, that is happening in the secondary also. First half cycle when you took, the A is at higher potential than B, diode is under forward bias, conducts the current, and forward current into load resistor given you the output value. But when the negative half cycle, current is reversed and here the voltage is reversed, this become low potential than the B, and diode is comes to be under reverse bias and no current and no output voltage. For every wave or one signal, half the signal will be passed. Half the pulse is passed, negative half pulse is removed. Thus we get pulsating one directional variable DC. We get variable DC, one directional, but it is pulsate, zero maximum happens. This is what the half wave rectifier as per board exam concern. But I can talk about some words here about the numerical problems concerned that may arising in entrance papers, national papers of NEET, JEE or so. What is the frequency of DC? Frequency of the rectifier output, half wave rectifier output. If I take the first term, the questions are coming even classically concept based. So here one frequency is completely here, one wave, one signal is coming. Half pulse is only output, half signal is coming. The frequency is not changed, frequency of AC equal to frequency of the half wave rectifier. If it has 50 hertz, it is also have 50 hertz. It has definite frequency because variable. Direction is not changing, therefore I am calling DC. But magnitude variable between 0 to maximum, therefore it has frequency equal to that of the AC. Second, if you want the power input AC. AC power input is, if you know the current, IRMS square into RL plus RF, where RL is the load resistance, RF is the forward resistance of the diode. RMS is the average current that is flowing through that AC. What is the power output across the load, DC output? IDC square into RL, because I square R is the power. I square R is the power, I square IRMS RL plus RF, that if you directly given. Suppose it is converted IDC square into RL only, we are drawing the DC across this load. What is the efficiency of this is power output by power input? If you taken here, the ratio of this IRMS by, actually I have to write IDC square by IRMS square into RL divided by RL plus RF into 100, if I did, you will get 40.6 into RL by RL plus RF is the relation for efficiency of the half wave rectifier. What is the power input, power output and efficiency of the only 40%. 50% we maximally expected, because half signal is removed, 50% is lost, we cannot get it out. But 50% minimum can get, but there are some losses, no doubt, transformer and also in the diode, resistor if it is not an ideal diode. So then there is a 40% maximum we expect in the half wave rectifier. What is the ripple factor? The word ripple factor. Ripple factor R is RMS value of current, AC current, RMS AC value in output. That is, AC component is existing here. I not shown there is small the component of that of the minority carriers in the reverse bias. And also this is pulsating one, has a definite frequency. there is an RMS value of AC present in the output of the rectifier to the DC current. DC current ratio, IDC to IRMS value of current in the output circuit, not input, output. This ratio is found to be very high, more than 1. Ripple factor is found to be around 1.21 for the half wave rectifier. RMS value of current, AC current to DC current ratio at the output. More simple I say, RMS value of AC output to DC current, AC current to DC current at the output. It is found to be very high. The filtering is less. And if you take the maximum current, I naught, if you want maximum current expression, I naught is nothing but V maximum, V naught divided by RL plus RF. Maximum output current divided by the load resistance and forward resistance of the diode gives you the maximum current. I can go for the I average current can be obtained by I naught by pi. I naught by pi in case of half wave rectifier. So if you want the I RMS current, RMS value of current output of the rectifier, this is equal to I naught by 2. There is a 50%. So then we call it as a form factor. Form factor, which is nothing but I RMS by I average. Form factor is I RMS by I average, which is found to be equal to, if I take the ratio, it is pi by 2, around 1.57. So there are some informations you must required to answer the questions in entrance. For board exam, these details are not necessary. But for entrance, you have to answer, means you must know what is the frequency of output of the half-wave rectifier, what is the power input, power output, efficiency, what is the percentage of efficiency of the output, ripple factor, AC current output to DC current output. Ripple factor value is around 1.1, maximum current, where RL is the load resistance, voltage by current, RF is the forward resistance, peak voltage. I average I naught by pi, I RMS I naught by 2, form factor is I RMS by I average. This is what the half wave rectifier concerns. Small changes if I did, I can get the full wave rectifier. No major changes. Another one diode is required minimum to get that one. What changes we will do, let us see. This I am keeping as it is, no changes in this. Let us remove and write neatly, whiter there few minutes we may use. But it gives you the clear picture. Here and there correction is not ideal. This I keep as it is. What changes comes, you will understand properly. This also I remove. Now coming to the second one, most important for the board exam concerned for 5 marks, full wave rectifier, the electronic device which converts complete wave of the AC into DC, we call it as a full wave rectifier. So in this, what the changes will come to know. This is nothing but AC signal we give here. Is a transformer A dash B dash, primary of the transformer, voltage input AC. Here we use the center tapping transformer, and instead of one diode we are using the two diodes. That are the two major changes we do here. Both the N region of the semiconductor junction diode are short. So n regions of both D2 and also D1, EN9P. And here center tapping P is connected with a load resistor. Here we draw the input. Output is drawn through these two. It is a load resistor, is connected to this. If I called these two ends are Q and S. So now what you are seeing is a full wave rectifier circuit. Changes did, I hope you are following. It is remains at zero potential. Now we draw the output here and we have to see the output signal across that. So I take again back the wave which as input AC wave. So way in. So this plus minus is carried out. And here the output pulse we get through this V0. So how this appears, let us see. So as usual explained earlier, if you take the first one, D1 comes under forward bias, D2 comes under reverse bias for the first half cycle. How that happens, let us see. This is negative and this is positive if I take, and current flows in this direction, in the anti-clockwise direction. Now this remains as zero. Reversal of polarity is there and this become at higher potential than zero and it is at lower potential than zero. It appear to be at lower potential, reversing of polarity. A comes to be here and B comes to this. It is at zero means it is higher than zero, higher potential. It is at a lower potential than zero. So therefore, when negative is connected to the P, we remove that, okay. Minus 2P and plus 2N, it is reverse biased. Plus 2P and minus 2N is a forward bias. Now this is forward biased, this signal which I given at the input, diode 1 is forward biased and conducts the current and comes the current like this, flow in this. Current flows through this directly. So it is the V0 we draw, current flow like this. It is the I due to D1, current due to D1, that I can say it is flowing from Q to S, direction you see, Q to S. Q to S at the load, current flown, D2 is reverse bias, no current at all. Here D2 is reverse bias. So therefore we got the pulse of the positive pulse with the help of the diode D1, not by D2. D2 is reverse bias, negative potential connected to the positive terminal, therefore it won't conduct. This is conducted in the first half cycle of the AC signal and we got the variable DC signal for D1. Let us come to the another half, remaining half. This negative signal, when you take this, D2 is get forward bias and D1 get reverse bias. Now D1 get reverse bias, D2 is forward bias. Current direction changes and now it is appear to be negative potential and it is appear to be at the positive potential. Now I say this is not true. This is stopped. But this is become positive. Now D2 is at higher potential than 0 and it is becoming negative, positive, this is negative, lower potential. Now already for D1, in the previous case, we got current Q to S, okay. Now this also conducted the current in the same sense, because this is forward biased, this is reverse bias. Now you see D2 current due to D2, it is current due to D1. In the first half,
positive cycle. Now it is the negative half cycle, D2. It is also flow from Q to S. Current through this is same, but D2 is forward biased. Current is due to D2 only. The current which is coming in this is D2 only, not by D1 in the next half cycle. Now this is a negative pulse come at the cost of D2, but D1 is absent. Now D1 is absent. Again come to the next positive half cycle, the same repeats. What you will see that D1 is conducting. At the cost of D1 you will get the output. D2 is reverse bias. Again negative half cycle you take. What happens to this negative half cycle when you took? Then it is a negative half cycle comes due to the cost of D2. Continuous pulse is obtained. No break at all. Entire wave is transmitted. And it is unidirectional but variable. There is a 0 to maximum. 0 to maximum is going on. But continuous signal is appearing. So full wave is converted into DC. Entire AC signal is converted into a pulsating variable DC signal. We call it as a full wave rectifier. I hope you are understood what we discussed here. This is enough for your discussion. For board exam, the question appears. The waveforms must be perfectly have to show. It is a AC waveform. It is a DC waveform. Output DC waveform. Output DC waveform of full wave rectifier V0 and T. These symbols also most important to show VN and T, how the signal is in the first half cycle. D1 conducts, current flows from Q to S, D2 do not, and in the next half cycle D2 conducts, D1 does not. But whether D1 conducts or D2 conducts, here it is clockwise and makes the current to flow from Q to S. When D2 conducts, current in the anti-clockwise direction in the lower circuit flows, and current again shows from Q to S. Across the output, current is unidirectional. Across the QS, whether D1 conducts or D2 conducts, it is unidirectional, and hence we got the output as continuous variable pulsating DC. That you have to, thus entire input signal of AC is converted into DC in case of full wave rectifier. This is the circuit and explanation. As this is for board exam, as for entrance concerned, what the changes comes if you want to see. See the frequency, I am changing all these 9 points are very important. What changes comes? What is the full wave rectifier, half wave, no, full wave rectifier comes, what may be the means double? Signal become, one signal become two signals here. These are the two pulses, frequency will be doubled. One signal becoming the two signals, and frequency of the full wave rectifier output is two times the frequency of AC. If the frequency of AC is 50, then frequency of the rectifier output is 100, doubles. If it is 100, it becomes 200, double than, two times the frequency of AC is the frequency of this. Power in, no problem, same, no variation. Power output is also no variation, we are across the load. But because of doubling, here if you take, it will be doubled. If you doubled 40.6 into 2, because once D1, another D2, both are helping, efficiency doubled, 40.6 plus 40.6, you will get 81.2. Maximum 81.2 into that RL by RL plus RF. That gives you the efficiency of that. And coming to ripple factor is more than 50% reduced. It is coming to be around 0.486 order, less than 50%, 0.5, less than 0.5 takes the value. Whereas coming to this V0 RL plus RF, V0 you have output load resistance and forward resistance of the diode. I average 2I0 by pi, because both diodes are helping, two signal is complete, it is doubled. IRMS's original value comes I0 by root 2.
I naught by root 2. When come to the form factor, it becomes, when take the ratio, 2 pi by 2 root 2, which is equal to around 1.11 IRMS value. This is what we are seeing in case of the full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier, frequency doubles, power in, power output, efficiency is 81.2% increases, ripple factor is reduced to around 4.48. Remember, AC output current to DC output current ratio is ripple factor defined. I maximum, I average, I RMS value, if you know in case of AC circuits, RMS value of AC and average value of AC same. Form factor is IRMS to I average ratio is reduced. In case of half wave, it is around 1.5. Here it is coming to be around 1.11. So those relations, numerical problems may appear in the entrance. But the question here, we discussed the two. This is the two are the major questions every year appeared, one or the other, half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier, correct diagram, circuit diagram, and also the waveforms input and output for full wave and half wave, and correct explanation is necessary. Rectification means converting AC into DC. The process is called rectification, and half wave only is rectified, we call it as half wave rectifier. An entire full wave is rectifying, then we call it as a full wave rectifier. Remember, in this case of rectification, only variable DC is coming, it is not a steady DC. But you are using such rectifier circuits in household appliances, like just you are more oftenly using the charger. Step down transformer is using, because 230 volt your charging rate is required about 2 to 5 volt. Step down transformer and steady DC voltage is required for that, where we use this full wave rectifier. But steady output is required rather than this variable. To get the steady output, filter circuit is used, RC filter circuit. What that is, let us see. With that, I conclude today's class. So I hope you have followed correctly the half wave and full wave rectifier. I think I am coming to get the steady DC from variable DC or output of the rectifier. To obtain steady DC output from a rectifier output, it is connected. It is means output. It is connected to a RC filter. The filter circuit, or I can say capacitor filter, better to say it, connected to capacitor filter circuit. How this take place in the filter circuit? Let us see. So you can think it is a filter circuit, sorry, rectifier. This is the input, AC input signal, and here you get output DC output or variable DC. So this variable DC output is connected to a capacitor and across the load. Then the output is drawn. This is a capacitor. The output of the rectifier, when connected to the capacitor circuit of this, we will get the output. This output how appears? Let us look into that. However, you can take a full wave rectifier. The same holds good for half wave also. The signal input, if you look into, it is a input AC completely pulsating both in magnitude and direction, plus and minus, that you have learned. When come to here, rectifier output is pulsating one. So like this, it is variable with respect to time. So its magnitude is maxima zero happening. That means no doubt it has a definite frequency. Here the voltage is, for example, if I take 5 volt, 0, 0, 5, 0, 5 is appearing if in absence of capacitor. Already you learnt about the capacitive reactance. One term I tell you here. Why we selected? Because it is a mixture of AC and DC. That is what I told, ripple factor. Ripple factor in case of, that is in the output, what is the AC component present against the DC component. Even in full wave rectifier, about 0.5% of, 0.5, the value of AC present. This mixture of AC, I have to filter off AC to get a constant DC. Pulsations should be removed and constant DC can be obtained. As it has the mixture of two, how we can filter, because you studied in the capacitive reactance to pi fc, where f, it has a frequency, no doubt you come to know frequency is nothing but 2 times the frequency of AC that we have supplied here, frequency of AC. It has that much of frequency. However, if you take the high value of capacitor, reactance become very low. The output, it is always zero, grounded. But here the output what we receive, now it is gets charging. Because of high capacitance value, time constant RC is made large. Time constant is made large, reactance is made very less, easily the capacitor will be charged, part of it flow in that direction, but capacitor charging starts. If you not provided this, for example, if it is absent, think absent, then capacitor will be charged to a maximum value and stops, because you have studied the property of capacitor, it is not bypass the DC, it can bypass only the AC. Here the AC component may be bypass, but the charge which is gained in the half cycle. So 0 to 5, when it reaches from slowly 0 to 5, this will be charged to a maximum value. Further it cannot be charged if it is absent. But when slowly the 5 to 0 coming, when this polarity is decreasing, keep it 0. It reached 5, then again coming to 0, this now liking to discharge. This decreasing voltage, you think that discharging through this load resistor take place. So charging took place, some voltage may go through this and majority will come and charge the capacitor. If load resistance is absent, it will be ceases. It is charged and stops. But there is a discharging provision because of frequency existing. As this voltage is decreasing of the rectifier output, capacitor discharges and compensate, that is the gain here, this loss it is compensating and value reaches to the higher.
That means this decrease and increasing is ceased and almost runs at the higher level. The loss at the next pulse, you are seeing the discharging. Again, it is discharging is supported and almost a value reaches here. Suppose this pulsation, now the current may appear like this. For example, I show the current earlier, it may be like this. Now this become absent because of charging and discharging of capacitor. In the half of the half cycle, it charges. Another half cycle, it discharges. During discharge, that supports this lower value and increases. Thereby, a constant output voltage, or I can say, because of this technique of discharging and charging, I used a high value of C. RC value is time constant is large, means charging and discharging is very fast. When it is taking at a higher rate, the voltage across the capacitor remains almost constant. These two are in parallel. The charging and discharging is a very higher rate. The voltage appears to be constant. That is appeared at the load, and that is nothing but Vc equal to V naught comes across the load. If you are selected higher and higher value of C, if you selected higher and higher, more smoothening is started. If you select a lower value of C, time constant decreases. When time constant decreases, slowly charging and discharging take place. Then this variation is again appearable here. You have to minimize the variation in appearance. Select a high value of capacitor. Make RC value large, time constant large. Reactance least. Charging and discharging made faster. Thereby, the load resistance will get constant output. A constant DC output appear in the out of the rectifier. There are three stages. To get a steady known value of DC from the rectifier, first you have to connect AC to a transformer. You first step down as a AC value to your need. Suppose if a 250 volt AC, you want 5 volt, you first step down to nearly to that value by transformer. Then use a full wave rectifier and pass that one to the full wave rectifier. You will get the pulsating DC. Then it connected to the capacitor filter of AC components, and make the constant DC voltage to appear. Keep the C value large. Make the time constant high. Reactance must be very low so that constant DC output will appear. Thus, a capacitor filter circuit converts pulsating DC into a steady DC. Rectifier converts AC into pulsating DC. Transformer step down or step up the input voltage to your required value. All these three together in series. First, you decide what voltage required through the transformer. Select required transformer of that nature and pass the AC. Convert it to full wave rectifier as a pulsating DC. Then you pass it through the filter to get steady value. Then connect to device to get that. Stabilized constant DC output will come continuously. This is what half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier and filter circuit give you, the constant steady DC outputs. DC output will come. There is a bridge rectifier called as. So even in that case, you will see the circuit of this forum. So you can give the input across these two. If you given the input AC, we can draw the output from this across the load. Bridge rectifier is called. So D1, D2, D3, D4. Across AB, we give the input. Across CD, we can draw the output across the load. Functioning is same. Instead of two diodes, four diodes may be employed in that.
Sometimes filter circuit along with the full wave rectifier may be shown to you at the end before conclusion of this. I hope you are understood clearly what is full wave rectifier, half wave rectifier and filter circuit. How this is, this is the AC source connected to a transformer. This output comes to diode D1, short circuited to diode D2, and here this center tapping is taken through this with an output at this point. Capacitor is connected, filter circuit and load resistor through which we can get the output. Load resistance, capacitor, transformer, AC circuit. This will give you the full wave rectifier filter circuit. Not important, just for your interest I given you. With this, in the next class, today we discuss this in detail and most important one for your board exam concerned out of these forward bias, reverse bias and PN junction diode along with full wave rectifier and half wave rectifier how it functions. For numerical problems concerned, those equations which we discussed in both, whether it is in a PN junction or it is in half wave full rectifier, must go through carefully. In the next class, we will discuss about the voltage stabilizer through Zener diode and optoelectronic devices. Fine, thank you.